Hey guys, this is Space Train, your daily express till the edge of the space. And today we will talk about what is the space-time? Grab your tickets and let's go. Our train will explore the whole universe to find answers to some important questions. So make sure you have subscribed to get unlimited pass on our expedition. To understand this mysterious world, scientists and physicists gave a lot of theories and concepts in which many successful and unsuccessful. In 1905, Albert Einstein gave his special theory of relativity, which changed all the physics. In 1915, Einstein gave general theory of relativity, which became very popular in the future. Space-time is the famous word associated with both of these. Today these two principles have passed more than 100 years. But it still remains a mystery to the scientists, physicists and students. It is easy to understand it, but it is a bit difficult to understand and use it in nature. We will talk about on the space-time. We will explain what the space-time is and why it needs and its benefits, so let's start. Newton initially told that our space is flat, there is no curve of any kind. They used simply 3D to reproduce any item like the Cartesian coordinates. It contains three axes x, y and z. So, according to Newton, we need only three dimension x, y and z to define an object. And he told that space and time are different. According to them, the time is constant and space and time are equal for all observers. For example, if you spend an hour in the universe, then it will be equal to everyone and everyone will spend an hour. But does that happen? If we take a little bit of scientific information, it does not happen. Einstein also said that this is not the case. According to them, to measure an event, we need time along with space, and time is not equal for all observers. For this reason, he gave special theory of relativity. At the moment, we focus on space-time. According to Einstein, space-time is relative, that is, space does not exist without time and time does not exist without space. This means that we cannot walk in space without time. If we have to walk in space, then we have to walk in time also. Similarly, if we want to move in time, then we have to move in space. For example, we can display this as a coin in general. If a part of coin is considered space and the other part is considered time, then a coin reproduces the space-time. From this, we can say that coins exist in the space and time together. None of the space or time is exist alone. We can understand this from a simple example. Suppose you want to go on a date with your girlfriends, then you will have to tell your girlfriend about the place, space, and date, time. If you do not tell any of these, then you can't date. Finally, what is the space-time? In physics, space-time is any mathematical model that fuses the three dimensions of space and the one dimension of time into a single four-dimensional continuum. Space-time diagrams can be used to visualize relativistic effects such as why different observers perceive where and when events occur. Space-time is a fundamental requirement to maximize any event. Without space-time, we cannot measure any event. Many people link space-time with Albert Einstein, who proposed special relativity in 1905. However, it was Einstein's teacher, Hermann Minkowski, who suggested space-time, in a 1908 essay. His concept of Minkowski space is the earliest treatment of space and time as two aspects of a unified whole, which is the essence of special relativity. He hoped this new idea would clarify the theory of special relativity. Minkowski space-time is only accurate at describing constant velocity. It was Einstein, though, who discovered the curvature of space-time, gravity, and general relativity. In general relativity, Einstein generalized Minkowski space-time to include the effects of acceleration. Einstein discovered that the curvature in his four-dimensional space-time representation was actually the cause of gravity. According to Einstein, space-time is responsible for gravity. We all know that gravity is the force that takes place between two objects, depending on the distance between their mass and the two, it was told by Newton. But Einstein said that in reality gravity is the reason due to the curvature of space-time of any object. If a space-time is too much curved, then gravity will be too much. It is called Einstein's general theory of relativity. We will explain this in detail in next video. We can understand the curvature of space-time with a simple example. Believe there is a rubber seat or a sheet that we consider it is space-time. And there is a big ball that we place on the sheet somewhere in between, which we call sun. And we take a small marble which is a lot smaller than big ball, we consider it as our Earth. When we leave this marble on the sheet, it moves circularly and slowly approaches that big ball and moves in a particular type of orbit. Although this speed ends later, but we can understand from this how the Earth is moving around the sun due to space-time curvature of sun and gravity works. So we understood that where space-time is high, gravity is more. Like the black hole is have too much mass. So there's a lot of space-time curvature there too. That's why the black hole's gravity is so high that the ray of light cannot even come out. Another advantage of space-time is that with its help we can know the past of the event and the future. If we draw the graph between the time and space, then we can know what is the past and the future of an event. We can understand this from an example. Let I throw stones into any seawater, by which will become capricious. If we watch it to reduce time and make a graph between space and time, then it will be look like a cone. So, if we make this graph further, then we get the future of this event. And if we reverse the graph, then we get the past of this event. Similarly, we can understand the universe after the Big Bang with its help. Because of space, time curvature, time is different on other planets. It depends on how their mass curves space-time around them. Discovering that we live in a four-dimensional world took more than 20 centuries. So if we look at these optimistic ways, we may discover lots of other dimensions that may be around us, but we can't realize it at this moment. There are lots of questions left, so don't space out, and leave some space in your brain for answers. I hope you enjoy this video. If you want to see more, subscribe and click the bell button to get notifications on our latest videos. If you are still here, grab your knowledge and get out of my train.